Hi guys, today I'll be showing you how to bleed the ABS module on your car using a scan tool. You want to bleed the ABS module if you've worked on it or replaced it, or if you've changed any of the brake lines going to the ABS module. All these procedures introduce air into the module, which can make braking suboptimal and will also cause corrosion in the module. I'll be doing this on a 2017 Honda Accord, and although the procedure may differ across manufacturers, the good thing is that the tool will guide you exactly on the procedure for your car if it's supported. Now let's get this. Several scan tools can do this, however, I'll be using the Autel MP808TS. If you're just doing routine brake bleeding, as I'm about to do, you don't really need to bleed the ABS module. I just thought this would be a good opportunity to demonstrate the procedure. And with that in mind, some of the things that you're going to need for the procedure include brake fluid, a catch can with tubing that fits snugly over the bleeder nipple. 8mm works pretty well on Hondas and Toyotas. And lastly, a wrench for loosening and tightening the bleeder valve. This flare nut wrench minimizes the risk of stripping out the bleeder screw. I'll select service menu and then brake bleed. Next is to select the car that you're working on, which in my case is a 2017 Accord. Select hot functions. It gives you this warning, which really doesn't have any bearing with the procedure today. Select modulator bleed. This function requires time to be completed. To avert a low vehicle battery, connect a jumper battery or voltage source. At this point, I'll bring in the Locator 4-in-1 jump starter, which I reviewed some weeks back. Hook up the positive and negative terminals. The ABS module is one of those things that is quite sensitive to low voltage. I'll click OK. This function will bleed the system by inducing brake fluid into two lines of the VSA modulator. Before starting the procedure, check and fill the master cylinder reservoir to the max level. Press next when ready. The tool doesn't state what I'm about to do next, but since I'm going to be bleeding the brakes afterwards, instead of filling up to the max line, I go ahead to suck out the old fluid from the master cylinder reservoir, taking care not to go below the minimum line. It's good practice to keep a rag around the reservoir to ensure you catch any spills of brake fluid which could damage paintwork. And then fill up with this Honda .3 fluid. Be sure to use the fluid that is recommended for your car. Next, just to state here that the bleeding sequence for Hondas with ABS is different from a lot of other cars, so don't be alarmed by the order that we're going to go in. So starting from the front wheel of the driver's side, test conditions, stop engine, raise the vehicle, the car is already on jack stands, remove the wheels, I'm not going to do that, I'll be doing the procedure from under the vehicle, 4, shift to neutral, release the parking brake, 6, hang a catch can bottle above the caliper, attach the tubing and open the bleeder screw at the caliper. I'll keep the catch can on the ground so that you can see clearly when the fluid is coming out. The important thing to ensure here is that after attaching the tubing to the nipple, it should take a vertical or upward incline so that any air in the system moves away from the caliper or the bleeder valve and not necessarily going back to it. All this is done, I'll click next. The test will run for 40 seconds. Brake fluid will be pumped through the VSA modulator left front circuit to remove trapped air. Press next to continue. I click next and the auto bleed starts. As you can see, the tool has activated the left front modulator of the ABS to bleed the air out of the system. While some models will require an assistant to pump on the brakes, it's just good that you don't have to do that on Hondas. Test is finished. Tighten the bleeder screw, top off the brake fluid as needed, press next when ready. Bleeding the left front modulator circuit is now complete, and it tells you to move your catch can slash tubing to the front passenger or right front bleeder valve, attach the tubing and then open it. I'll have that done. For the right, I'll place the catch bottle above the caliper this time, and next. And it tells you the same thing for the right side, next. And as you can see, it begins to bleed the right part of the ABS circuit. Test is finished. Tighten the bleeder screw, top off the brake fluid as needed, press next when ready. Modulator bleed function test has been completed, and it tells you to perform the normal brake bleeding procedure. This is to expel any air that is left in the lines. I'll click OK. Turn ignition switch off, turn ignition switch on. That's done. Time for me to bleed my brake fluid per routine maintenance. Hope this was helpful. Catch you on the next one. Peace.